Are we still sisters?
Nothing is ever going to change that.
With psychosis, you're always dealing with just this person, but they're dealing with everyone else inside.
Yeah.
The idea of the person that you knew is gone, mourn them, let them go.
Yeah.
It is true that they're not going to come back as they were. Our experiences change us, they shape us, they mold us. Yeah. There is no putting the genie back in the bottle.
She's not coming back as 9-year-old powder.
Yeah, but she can find that decency again. You really get into Vi's headspace of what is my sister capable of? There's real fear there.
Yeah.
And Vi is not a character who gets scared. My opinion, my headcanon, is it started as an act, and it came to be something that she believed.
It's Jinx now. Powder fell down a well.
The actual caring is buried in there, and it comes to the surface whenever she's around her sister. People change and evolve over time, and when you choose to love somebody, you're choosing to love a different version every day, every month, every year. Because if you just love the original,
you're in love with someone that doesn't exist anymore. Hello and welcome to Cinema Therapy. I am Alan Seawright, professional filmmaker who needs therapy, and that guy is...
Jonathan Decker, licensed therapist who loves movies as well as the occasional Netflix series. What are we doing today?
Well, the cat's out of the bag. This is only our most requested episode ever. We're going to talk about Arcane.
Oh my freaking gosh. We love
you. League of Legends Arcane.
So we're doing it. But we're going to talk about Vi and Jinx. Is that what I'm focusing on?
We are
going
to talk about Vi and Jinx.
Okay.
Because it's the central relationship for the entire series.
So I don't know a lot about the world or where or when this takes place, but we do have a city that is above and a city that is below.
Yep.
And it's very class struggle.
Yeah.
And Vi and Jinx both come from below. Their parents are killed in a civil war. They're adopted by...
Vander.
Vander, who was...
Fantastic character. Love him to death. We lost you too soon, Vander. In the arms
of the angel. He was hella cool right out of the gate. Jinx goes by Jinx because she messes things up. She's very clumsy. And she tries to help, and her trying to help results in the deaths of her friends.
Right.
I was shocked. I was like...
It hit like an exploding door.
Holy Christ. Oh, wow. This child just accidentally killed her friends trying to help, and now her sister hates and blames her for it. And their daddy is all... Their adopted father is also dead.
After really, being turned into a weird giant drug monster.
And so now we have years later, the sisters are separated. And Jinx thinks that Vi hates her, and Vi immediately regretted lashing out.
Mm-hmm.
But here we are.
Well, I love the
like, this is what
film
her sister
scratches
used to do.
And like drawings on the film.
Yeah.
To represent her mental state.
But her sister used to go after this machine, and so now she's getting her rage out. Oh man.
Still came in second.
Yeah. Oh, man.
That's where her mental state is. I love that scene for a whole bunch of filmmaking reasons, but let's talk about what we're learning about her first.
She carries a lot of grief and a lot of guilt and also a lot of anger at her sister for abandoning her.
Sure.
And her sister almost immediately tried to come back.
Yeah, her sister did abandon her, but... Immediately regretted it and
tried to come back, but then she was imprisoned.
Right.
Right. And so there's layers here, but she feels like her sister left her and left her as a child. And so she carries a lot of guilt, a lot of rage, a lot of anger and feelings of abandonment. So this is catharsis. I mean, this is, we talk about this a lot, releasing your anger in a way that doesn't hurt anybody. This is one of the rare times that Jinx releases her anger in a way that doesn't hurt anybody.
This episode is brought to you by Valencia Home Theater Seating.
This is so cool.
It's what we're sitting in right now.
We have our own luxury, personally made theater chairs.
Behold the embroidered characters from our Heroes website.
First of all, the chairs that we sat in the old place were not especially comfortable.
They caused me back pain.
And they looked like butts. Everybody said so. We never acknowledged it. Now that it's done.
They did. These ones, significantly more ergonomic.
Mm-hmm.
Full grain leather.
I don't feel tired at the end of our shoots from the core strength required to hold myself upright from like the last ones. Here, the chair holds me upright.
So go to ValenciaTheaterSeating.com. We are currently sitting in the Syracuse model. They light up. They're each individual recliners, which are very comfortable.
Mm-hmm.
They're all automatic. They have models with headrests that lean forward.
Last shoot, I was like, I'm tired. I need to take a nap. Where should I take a nap? And I thought, I'm sitting in it. The Valencia home theater seats come with a USB port right here.
Every single seat can charge your phone.
The cup.
I'll wait.
The cup holders are super nice.
So thank you, Valencia Home Theater Seating, for sponsoring the movie cave.
We lost our minds when they said we want to give you theater seats. We were so excited. Honestly, if you're building a home theater, these are the best seats you can get.
Click the link in our description below or go to ValenciaTheaterSeating.com to get your custom amazing home theater or fancy room seating.
Fancy smancy. It feels revolutionary when you're watching.
Feels like you haven't seen stuff like this.
It is. And not in a way that you would expect.
How so?
A whole bunch of the animation, like first pass at a bunch of stuff, was done with a game engine.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then animators went through and did a bunch of other stuff. So like, I don't know if you noticed, but most of the effects stuff, smoke, flames, water splashing, things like that, that's all hand animated.
Mm.
So it's like cel-shaded stuff. The characters are CG with hand-drawn textures on them. The lighting is sort of painted in instead of being real interactive light, which is what you normally do in a CG environment. So much of the storytelling is influenced by the art design, and it's just kudos.
Yeah.
Everybody who worked on this, you obviously did work.
A lot of amazing emotional range that you see in the animation. The vocal work is fantastic. And then the fights are some of the coolest fights I've ever seen.
Some of the best animated fights ever put on film.
Yeah. Just
really good.
Because you talk a lot about weight in animation. And if it doesn't carry weight, if it doesn't... And you feel every hit in the show. It's rare that you watch something animated where you feel like the characters are in danger and you worry about that.
Yeah. And in this, it's constant. It's just things feel like they hurt. All kinds of, it's stuff that you don't get out of animation very often.
Powder? Vi? Oh, Powder!
She looks like such a little girl with her expression in those shots.
Yeah.
I'm so sorry, Powder. I tried to come back. I promise I did, but I got arrested. Marcus. I don't know. It doesn't matter. I never thought I'd see you again. Are you real? Yes, of course.
Part of why she's asking that is because she experiences psychotic symptoms.
Right, yeah, I really want to talk to you about those.
Things changed when you left. I changed. I know, Pow-Pow, I know. You did what you had to do to survive. Me too. It's okay. What matters is we're together.
That's a really beautiful exchange.
Yeah. Well, and then Caitlin has to come ruin it.
There's definitely PTSD here.
Yeah.
And there's with a touch of psychosis. Now, when I say the word psychotic, when you hear the word psycho, the public hears the word psycho and they think, right, dangerous and crazy. What psychotic actually means is that there's a break from reality. It could be delusions, okay. Where you think that things are happening that aren't actually happening, which does happen a lot with Jinx.
Sure, yeah.
Everyone shut up! I need to think. Do you hear that?
Or where she suspects things about people, or that this person is going to betray her, or this thing is going to happen. And in her case, it's based on very real experience.
Mm-hmm.
You hear voices that nobody else hears. You see things that nobody else sees. And she has these interactions with these other beings.
I'm in no mood. We didn't say anything.
And it's not the same thing as dissociative identity disorder, because in those cases, those are different personalities living in the same person, and one comes out at a time.
Right.
with psychosis, you're always, if you're on the outside, you're always dealing with just this person, but they're dealing with everyone else inside.
Yeah.
Right. So that's yeah. the biggest difference. But a lot of this stems from trauma. And in her case, it's very much true. I love the, we did what we had to survive. We both did. Here it really pops. They've both kind of become violent, do what you have to do to survive monsters.
Yeah.
And yet when they see each other and they well up, you know, I just think it's, it hits. It hits so hard.
It's really, really well done.
I didn't lose her. They took her.
Getting even deeper into her psychosis.
Yeah. She was there for me, not the enforcer. Remember her name. But why would I remember her name? Well, she's just some stupid topsider. Yeah.
What does she eat? I never caught this. What
she's stapling her leg together.
Is that? That's what I thought that was, but yeah. I wasn't sure.
Caitlin.
Yeah, she's hardy. Oh my gosh. That would be exhausting.
And then here's your iconic shots for 1,000, Alex. Well, that scene pulled literally zero punches. That's everything. They fired the whole gun.
Filmmaking?
Possible. Here's how to show that someone is psychotic. We're putting scratches on the film, and then we've scratched drawings into the film. All those white things.
Yeah.
They're doing speed ramps, so things are getting slower and faster and slower and faster. There's sound in surround sound that's like traveling around her and the little giggles and everything. Yeah. So, you know, we're getting it in the sound, we're getting it in the visuals, a whole bunch of different ways. The mirror is broken, and there's a hole in it, and her eye always lines up with the hole, except at the very end when it doesn't, and her eye is just off center, and it shows like 9 of her eyes all the way around in each of the shards. It's just more and more fracturing and breaking apart and just getting worse and worse. And it's, I mean, they gave it both barrels. Like, that's everything.
I should have been there. For you. For everyone.
That's a good way to drive yourself crazy.
This was a young boy.
Maybe none of this would have happened.
He's now older.
He'd be dead.
Yeah.
Or changed.
Powder's gone, Vi. All that's left is Jinx, and she belongs to
Sophie. You're wrong. She's still in there. I can reach her.
You can't.
I know my sister.
I got one more thing to show you.
So I want to talk to you about what Vi is experiencing, because she's not having the obvious, you know, psychological break that Jinx is, but she's obviously dealing with some shit too.
This is everyone we've lost. The price of our freedom. Some of it was enforcers. Most was Silco. Your sister works for him not because she has to, but because she wants to. I'm sorry, but that's who she is now.
The idea of the person that you knew is gone, mourn them, let them go.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's a really healthy idea, you know? Your grandparent has Alzheimer's and they're here in body, but they're not here otherwise, and they don't remember anything. Versus, you've got a person carrying a lot of guilt, a lot of shame, a lot of anger and sadness and grief, and they're not making good life choices.
Yeah.
You know, I would actually side with Vi here. I always think there's hope for someone like that. That's why I do what I do.
Yeah.
You know, it is true that they're not going to come back as they were. Our experiences change us. They shape us. They mold us. Yeah. There is no putting the genie back in the bottle.
She's not coming back as, what, 9-year-old Powder.
Yeah. This is completely unpredictable. At least it was to me.
In a very good way.
Yeah. There are so many things that even though I thought it was heading in this direction and it goes a hard left.
Yep.
And generally in a way that is exciting or stimulating or shocking or upsetting, but not in a... But always satisfying. Even the stuff that's upsetting is not a stupid storytelling decision. I'm like,
no, it's great.
You were trying to hurt me and piss me off because I'm invested in these characters, and you did it.
Thanks, Riot.
Marcus never told me she was in Stillwater.
But you found out she came back. You lied.
She has a thing about lying that we're going to talk about.
What?
She and the Enforcer are back for the crystal. Not for you. Have you forgotten how she left you? Who found you? Who cared for you? Gave you a home? I am your family. Everyone else betrays us. I need you. Now more than ever.
Fascinating character, though. Really, really good.
But in her case, is she with lying?
You lied.
What's her thing with lying? Talk to me about this. Like, why is this such a trigger for her?
If I look back at her, because early on, Vi was straightforward with her when they were kids. Vi told her what was going on. So did Vander. So there wasn't a lot. There's not a lot of trauma centralized around lying. I'd say it's secondary. Like it's related to abandonment. Meaning, she felt like her sister betrayed her, and so
her sister promised that she would, you know, stay with her, and then didn't.
Yeah.
So I guess is that the lie trauma
that's
that we're dealing
probably
with?
Probably ground zero for it.
Okay.
Especially because I need to be able to trust to feel safe. My parents died. I had my sister. I had this group of friends, but the group of friends didn't want me around, and my sister stood up for me, and then she left.
Please, I need you, baby.
Vander died. I'm thinking that for her, lying is tied to trust.
Okay.
I don't feel safe without trust. And if there's not honesty, there's no trust. You say you're always going to be there for me, but if you lie about other things, are you lying about that?
Right.
And so she needs honesty, and we all do, but for her, it's a real...
It's like a need, like oxygen.
Yeah, I want to see season 2, what happens there.
Shut up. It's just a goodbye hug.
Yeah, not a whole ton to do with Caitlin this season, but there's a lot of fodder for, like, mixed loyalties.
Yeah, there's seed planting.
Yeah.
Right now we're focused on Vi and Jinx, and that's true for a lot of the season. I mean, there's subplots, but this is the plot. Oh, Marcus.
Friggin' Marcus.
Like, I know you want to look out for your kid, but come on.
Yeah, don't humanize the corrupt cop. Just let him be corrupt.
Liar.
There it is again.
Well, I don't know if that's a weakness of the series, but it refuses to have one-dimensional characters.
I think it is honestly a weakness because there are some supporting characters that can just be supporting. Just let them support. We don't need a 5-minute explainer on, no, but they're really three-dimensional. It's like, cool. I'm sure the guy walking past in the background is too. There's an episode about him. Great.
that's a bit much. But I appreciate if they err on the side of making everyone three-dimensional.
Oh, definitely lean that way more than the other way.
It's a refreshing change.
Everyone's
of pace.
A stock character.
Yeah.
What happened to her? It's not your fault.
When my parents were still alive, me and Powder used to share a bed like this, except maybe half the size. We played a game where we pretended to be bigger and bigger monsters. So she would say, I'm a slug monster with venom for ooze. And I would say, well, I'm a slug eating crab with razor spikes. Sometimes I'd get carried away and she'd get scared. I didn't want her to start crying and wake my parents up, so I pretended to chase my own monsters away. I'd say, no monster's gonna get you when I'm here. Then a real monster showed up. And I just ran away. I left her.
I mean, I would say what Vi needs here is the recognition of, you were a child, your friends literally just died in front of you. Mm-hmm. Your surrogate father died to protect you. And your sister, not intentionally, caused it.
She was at fault. You were not wrong.
It wasn't murder, but it was definitely manslaughter.
Yeah.
Of all these people that you cared about. And as a child, you lashed out at her and ran away. And the fact that you were so quick to turn around, like, it was within a couple
within
minutes.
Within a couple of minutes, you changed your mind about it. Like, that's a remarkably good person.
I tried to come back. I promise I did.
And to say it was an accident and she's small and she needs me, and then you got taken and put in jail. I mean, I come back to this a lot, the concept of guilt. What purpose does it serve? Her guilt serves no purpose here. Her guilt isn't helping her to reconcile.
Right.
Her guilt isn't helping her to change a behavior that she hasn't already changed. It's literally just consuming her. And so by all means, her mission to redeem her sister and save her sister and help her sister, she should continue on with that.
Mm-hmm.
But she can let go of the baggage that she's carrying.
Right.
And I think we all can. Does your guilt serve a purpose?
Initially, yeah, for sure.
If it's about a behavior that you chose that you can change, it serves a purpose, use it, and then release it. And if it's not either of those things, it shouldn't even be there in the first place.
Yeah.
It just needs to be let go of because it's not serving anything here.
Really thought I buried this place. But I should have known better.
Yellow eyes like a predator at night.
Those cat's eyes.
Yeah.
Never stays dead.
Because she's on the hunt now.
Are we alone?
Well, she's, you know, been repaired with the juice.
Maybe forever.
With...
What is this stuff called again?
Want to know a secret? Silco thinks he made Jinx. With all his rants and its hard-won lessons. Excise your doubts, Jinx. Be what they fear, Jinx. Like everything was the same as when Vander left him. But he didn't make Jinx. You did.
I'm sorry, Powder. I never meant to leave you.
You never left. I always heard you. Shadows in the streets. Prickles on the back of my neck. Your voice pushing me, picking me up when all the colors were black. You're the reason I'm still alive.
I spent so many nights in that shitty prison on that freezing floor, hungry, bloody.
What Jinx needs is a recognition of, yeah, I carry a lot of guilt for this, but my sister had a very human moment and lashed out at me. And when she tells me she came back for me, I can choose to believe that even if that scares me.
Are we still sisters?
Nothing is ever going to change that.
I always knew you'd come back.
What's going on?
What do you think of the line, are we still sisters?
I mean, it's really good writing. It's evocative. Strong line, having it over black, and then she lights up the thing.
It's, yeah, what's up with that?
What's up with that is they got some talented ass writers and directors working on this.
Because you really get into Vi's headspace of what is my sister capable of, and why am I here? And when you're black, and then suddenly it's light, and then she says, you know, what's going on? There's real fear there.
What did you do?
Yeah.
And Vi is not a character who gets scared.
Not a lot.
But Jinx is freaking her right the hell out right now.
Yeah, well, understandably. It's, and that's one of the things that I love about Jinx here, especially the further later we get into the series where she's really kind of, you know, losing it. But characters like that, she very much reminds me of Heath Ledger's Joker.
How so?
There's an animalistic, like she doesn't have a rationale behind a lot of her actions. It's just... chaos is fun.
Yeah. I'm like a dog chasing cars.
She is so beyond caring that she's just urges now.
Yeah.
And anything that in the moment is like, this seems crazy and weird and fun is like, I'm going to do that.
Yeah. Well, and I think when you say she's so beyond caring, I think she's beyond caring about what's right and wrong, what's acceptable or not. She still obviously cares about her sister.
Yeah, obviously.
There's the pain there is born of caring.
Right.
She tries to cover it by getting into this chaotic apathy.
Yeah, that's interesting. I hadn't actually read it that way, but it could be that it's an act.
Yeah. Well,
and it's hard to tell, and that's actually really good bit of, you know, performance by the animators and performance by the voice actress to get you to like, I don't know.
Well, you know how you can convince yourself of something? The whole, I think I can. You can also, my opinion, my headcanon is it started as an act and it came to be something that she believed.
Mm. Okay.
But the actual caring is buried in there, and it comes to the surface whenever she's around her sister.
Caitlin trying to make things better doesn't, as per usual.
Look out!
Oof.
Man, the shimmer stuff when people get moving around is super fun.
Now finish it.
Damn it, Powder! Wake up! Remember who you are, I know you remember! Picture Milo! Clagger! Stop, Vander!
Shut up! Don't listen to her!
Yes! Mom!
These aren't happy memories for her. These are demons at this point. Demons of the people that died.
Vi was good enough to get in her head and make her choose to save Vi from Silco.
We'll be okay.
At she the was cost gonna, of.
Yeah, because she was going to sit in the chair that said Powder or the chair that says Jinx. Which one do you want me to be?
And she saved Vi, but chose Jinx. That's just damn good filmmaking. What update? I don't know what I was going to say.
God, maybe you could love me like you used to. Even though I'm different. But you changed too. So, here's to the new us.
And that is valid about relationships. People change and evolve over time. I know my siblings have. I know my spouse has. I know my children have. I know I have.
Mm-hmm.
And when you choose to love somebody, you're choosing to love a different version every day, every month, every year. Because if you just love the original, like the one that you first met or the one that you first knew,
you're in love with someone that doesn't exist anymore.
Yeah. And that's very true as we grow and evolve, and especially as traumatic experiences, hardship, loss can shape us in positive ways. We can grow more compassionate, we can grow stronger, you know, more resilient, or we can become jaded and cynical and violent and pessimistic. But we all still just need love. All you need is love. This is a good recommendation. It's a good call.
It was. Thanks to all of you who pestered us for months and months and months to watch Arcane here on Cinema Therapy, not television or animated streaming series therapy.
This animated streaming service therapy, or AST.
You asked for it.
You're done. You're done.
Probably honestly wouldn't have watched it without that. And it's great. Yeah. Super great.
Keep telling us what the young people are watching.
Stay tuned. There's a villain therapy on Silco coming sometime in the next couple of months. And please let us know if there's any other, like, very limited series. We can occasionally do those.
Yeah, series that have, like, 100 episodes.
We're not doing
gonna,
it.
Yeah, it's not going to happen. But this type of stuff will start to make room if enough of you raise your voice and say, this one's worth it.
So, you know, upvote on Reddit or whatever.
No, that will never reach us. Leave a comment below. Let me explain to you how the internet works.
Huh?
Comment on our YouTube video and we will see that.
We're on YouTube?
Oh, man.
I'm a filmmaker. If it's not in a movie theater, I don't know what the hell it is. So until next time.
There's a monster inside of all of us.
Bit of advice. Don't threaten the guy who pours the drinks.
And watch movies. Series.
streaming series that are animated.
You should go and save yourself. Don't you have a-